this can't be right, can it? What goes up is gonna stay up? Hey guys, welcome back. MTG Moxman here. If you're new to my channel and you somehow found me out there in the wild west world of YouTube, well, thanks a lot for checking me out. I hope you enjoyed the content today. You can always find me 11:15 Eastern Standard Time. 6 days a week I will be there. And on the seventh day on the Sunday, I'm there in the evenings Eastern Standard Time around 8 o'clock at night. The video should be there, if not a few minutes before. All right, guys, every day of the week, you're going to have some Moxman. That's the way it should be. So I hope everyone's having a great day. We did some market research in the last few days, got some sales compiled for you, let you know how a few of the cards are doing, all right? So let's check out number one. Can you believe this? We are still talking about reserve list stuff this far in. The sales aren't really ending, by the way. There are cards calming down, but I'm not seeing retracement yet, which I expected to see. I saw a little tick of a couple of cards, but it hasn't dipped enough, and we will talk about that. Let's get to number one here. Let's get to the Sliver Queen. Her Majesty, the Royal One. That's right. I said it. The Royal One. Come on. She's a Sliver. She's a Queen. Kind of want to have her in every deck you can. She's kind of a nostalgic throwback awesomeness card. In my Sliver deck, I have her, Sliver Legions, Hive Guy. We got some great cards, man. And they still print Slivers now, which is amazing. There's still been sets with it. And of course, Time Spiral Remastered will have Slivers in it, which is kind of cool to have that throwback. I hope they put new Slivers in there. I always like seeing some Slivers. Now, guys, the sales are strong. I gotta be honest, man. I'm gonna buy my Sliver Queen for $15. Sliver sales are strong. Now, they're even selling non-English at this point because the English market is so decimated with almost no good pickings available that you're seeing a lot of the non-English cards get picked up. But the English sales I could kind of compile here, you can see, like, come on, people are asking $400 or $500, and then the sold listings, the non-English, forget that one at the bottom, it was 227, I forget what that one was, but you can see the other ones are like 400 for the English versions, it's $400. Okay, it's not coming back, and Stronghold didn't have a huge print run. So it's not coming back, and it's only going to get pricier, which, I'll be honest, my price memory at $15, I'm passively following this card. It is not on my list. But what happened was I was looking at my Sliver deck the other day, and I started looking up some of the cards, and that's when I came across it. Tracked it back for the last 90 days and just took a look. Consistent sales almost all the way through. Every day there's a few copies changing hands. Locally it sold out a long time ago. There was nothing local here. And then of course, internationally, you know, they're expensive. Okay, that's what I'm gonna tell you. It's expensive. Now, that said, it still has room to grow. This card is still gonna continue to go up, just like Mox Diamonds is from the same set. And I mean, there's boxes in Stronghold where I saw two or three of these opened in a box. I saw two Mox Diamonds sometimes, so the set's so small, you got a lot of that replication sometimes, and it went in your favor the odd time, which was cool. They don't really have that in the new set. So there's a lot of history with this card, a lot of fun times, a lot of magic lore around this card. So people have a very good price memory where they go, oh, this card was awesome. It's only gone up. It's wicked. And they only want it to go higher. So you're not going to see this card sold very often. It's going to be held by a lot of people. So way to go, Sliver Queen. You're rocking and you're still on your way up. Can you believe that's still on its way up at that price? Crazy. All right, next up is going to be Library of Alexandria. We've been following this for a while, and the sales are scary. I know, right? Scary! Now, what do I mean by scary? I mean there's like none left. Okay? This card was only in English. It has a small print run. There's almost none for sale. Where there used to be like 20, 30, 40 at any given time, there's like 10. And that's like including some like beat up copies and slab copies for a lot of money. BGS 5 for like $2,500 with like import fees put over like $3,000. I remember this card being like a $100 card. I remember as a teenager it being a $5 trade-in. Because it didn't give you a colored mana back then, right? That's what us kids were thinking. Guys, again, you can see there it's going to go, you know, higher. You can already tell. It's the print run that forces this card. And the fact that people call this one of the power of 10, right? Because of the fact, you know, you have the 7 cards, you tap it, you can draw another card. And there was lots of ways of abusing this card too, which was phenomenal. You could use with, like, I used to use with Candelabra of Thanos to, like, untap it multiple times in a turn. Get some Moxes in your hand, just click, click, click away. It was so cool. So, yeah, and of course, the sold listings are showing very strong. So don't be surprised when you see that. You're like, yeah, it's like three. You're right. $3,000 is a lot of money. $2,000 is still a lot of money. I bought one in the summer. Originally, I was going to put it up as one of the prizes way back in the day before I took it down because it's jumped up too much from where I trade. I just can't. So crazy to see those guys, but awesome. Library Alexandra, you're still climbing. And by the way, this card still has room to grow. I'm looking at settling in around $3,000 solid for a moderately played. So keep that in mind. My trajectory is dragging it that way. Oh, I got the wrong one there. Got the wrong one. All right. Vorost Stronghold. Now, I said this was settling past the $200 mark. It is getting close to there. But I've noticed the sales of English ones are slowing down. Non-English are being picked up. Okay? Non-English of this version are being picked up because why pay $200? You just want a real copy. You know what it does? You don't mind translating or you can kind of figure it out for yourself? Boom, why not? Okay? And that's what people are doing. And it had multiple sales of foreign language copies, guys. So this card is definitely on people's watch list. They want it, but they're not sure how they feel about paying $250 plus for this card. I still say it's going to settle higher. We are not done yet. This card will continue to go up as well. You notice what I said in the beginning of this thing? Everything's just going up and nothing seems to be settling right now. And from the information I've gotten from my patrons, as well as the emails, thank you very much with those stats about some of the things going on. That's kind of crazy. It's only going up and it looks like it's going to stay that well for a while longer. We're not going to see the retracement I thought in the next 30 days. It looks like we've got another 60 to 90 days before this stuff will start calming down as people continue to buy these cards, even after they're restocked. So there's a few people out there and they are hungry for these cards, okay? Like they're actively searching and seeking them out and they want them for the collections. In most cases, these appear to be players because it's players who have the FOMO fear of just not getting this card. They don't want to come back 10 years from now. I had a friend who was looking for a Black Lotus. He was honing in on it. He kind of doubted himself. And then they jumped like 30%. They're like 20 grand now. He can't get one. It's out of his reach. That's how I feel with the Cradle, right? So I understand, but these cards are only going higher. Vol'Ross Stronghold still, to me, has room to grow. It's going to continue. It's going to be a $500 card. Okay, it's going to go up. So get ready for it. I know. All right, Brain Geyser. We've been tracking this one for a while, haven't we, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, children of all ages? But look at this. It is settled. It hasn't retraced down to like the $15, $20 mark, but it's not going up either. The English copies that are like moderately played to light played, they're all hanging in there. There was a really beat up copy for like 20 something bucks. So if you had to get one, hey, grab it. It's only $20. But you can see these things here where you see, you know, sales for a bit, right? Right? You know, a little higher. You see that 90 something dollar one for near mint. They had some slab copies of 8.5s and 9s for like $200, but those are slabbed. Then you look at the ones for sale, you're saying, hey, that's not that bad. And it's not. Now, some of the shipping is bad. And there's a couple with import fees. So always pay attention when you're buying on eBay to see who you're buying from and what the fees that are associated. Because I can't buy from the people in the States who have the Pitney Bowes import fees because it just jacks it to the point where I can't afford it. You're adding 30% on your fees, right? And Pitney's just keeping the money. So it's ridiculous. So I don't buy from any seller who has those fees attached. I just skip them. I don't even look at them because I'm not paying those fees in Canada. But you can see that Brain Geyser is staying stable, but it hasn't dipped. So I'm waiting to see. This one I was figuring with Copy Artifact would have a slight bring back because it's never really been bought out before. But apparently not. Apparently it's going to hang in there at that $60, $70 level by the time it's all said and done with shipping. Or just $50 if you can afford to buy one. But none of my local stores have one anywhere. There are none. So you have to go online to find them, okay? I'm sorry. It's just the way it is. And our last card study of the day. It's going to be Lotus Veil. I'm going to add this one in. I thought it was interesting. You can see there, right? The people are selling it for like 180, 190, but there wasn't many for sale, like the English copies. And when I looked over, I said, hey, like this is not selling that high, but all these recent ones are coming up now. These jack up prices you're seeing have been in the last 4 or 5 days because the stock is almost gone. So although it's a weather-like card, there's just none available, which is kind of crazy to think about. But there's nothing you can do about it. There's just nothing for people to buy. So when the slim pickings get this way, some people get into a feeding frenzy and they're willing to pay a lot more than they normally would. Please don't fall for that. Wait for a restock to kind of happen. This card is not one that I think is going to jump to hundreds of dollars right away. It's going to take time to get there. And it has, you know, it's going to take, it's a good land, but it has drawbacks, right? You don't want to have a strip mine just tear out your land from you, right? So keep those things in mind. You'll be okay. Please put comments, questions, concerns in the comments section below. Pass these videos off to your friends. If you're new to the channel, hit up and subscribe to the channel. We're going to have some fun. It's going to be pretty awesome. And for those of you who stuck around to the end of this video, if you're hanging in there, well, maybe if you make it to the patron section, there might be something there for you. I wonder. Thanks a lot, guys. See you soon. Hey, guys. MTG Moxman here. I'm going to pick up the rest of the boosters for our booster lot sale for the 3K subscribers. It's going to be epic. Can't wait to show you guys what we have a chance to purchase. Going to be a lot of fun. Tune in this week. We got videos.